Good evening once again and welcome to the devotional. It's time to pray. I invite you to please pray with me. Shall we pray? Father in heaven, dear God, once more we thank you for blessing us this beautiful evening, O Lord. As we partake this heavenly manna, O God, inspire us. Give us the assurance of your loving presence, the wisdom from above, through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. Easy pray. Easy pray. Found in Numbers 25 verse 3. So Israel yoked themselves to the Baal of Peor, and the Lord's anger burned against them. When we think that we are safe, that is when we ought to hold on tighter on to the arms of God. We cannot depend on our own strengths, powers, and abilities. We must constantly trust the Lord our God. The book Patriarchs and Prophets, page 454, paragraph 1, describes how the Lord has blessed the Israelites during their encampment at the fertile valley of the Jordan River. While Moses was planning their journey to Canaan, something unimaginable happened. The Moabites started to entice the Israelites to do sinful things in the sight of God. The men began to indulge in sexual immorality with the Moabite women. They persistently invited them to offer sacrifices to their gods. The Israelites rejected God's precepts and instructions. Balaam suggested that they hold a great festival in honor of the Moabite gods. Because Balaam was regarded as a prophet of God, it was so easy to entice the Israelites to attend on that occasion. Patriarchs and Prophets, page 454, paragraph 3. Now Balak and Balaam were behind this plan to lead the Israelites into its downfall. The Israelites ate the sacrificial meals and bowed down to the Moabite gods. The Lord's wrath was ignited. The Lord brought a terrible pestilence in the camp, and about 24,000 people died from the plague. Numbers 25 verse 9. Now God commanded that the leaders involved in this immorality be put to death. Numbers 25 verse 4. Moses pronounced the judgment of the Lord, and the order was speedily executed. In Patriarchs and Prophets, at page 455, paragraph 1, it says that the offenders' dead bodies were hung up so that the whole congregation can fully reflect on how God truly hates sin. Indeed, the wages of sin is death, Romans 6:23. Now friends, we can be easy prey to sin if we allow the enemy to use us. The enemy is cunning, and he uses the people who are close to us to entice us into doing something against the will of God. We cannot trust our own judgment, but we can always trust God. Our selfish inclinations can easily lead us to destruction away from God's will and direction. We must not allow ourselves to become easy prey. Let us always trust in God and not ourselves. Trust God's wisdom instead of what we can do, because God knows it all and God knows what's best for us. Shall we pray? Father in heaven, Lord God, Lord, we can be an easy prey if we lose track, O God, holding tight unto your word, unto your promises, O Lord. I pray that you will bless each one of us, O God, that we will hold on tight unto your promises, believe what you can do in our lives, O God, and protect us, O God, please protect us from the snares of the enemy, O Lord God. Lead us to eternal salvation, O God, into the path of righteousness. Thank you for your grace, mercy, and love, and the message that we need right now. In the loving Jesus we pray. Amen. Thank you once again. I'm so happy you're here with me tonight. And I hope I see you again tomorrow night. May the Lord God bless you. Bye-bye.